हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर श्रद्धा शेरके फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। वेलकम टू अवर नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन दिस कोर्स डिजिटल सर्किट्स। इन दिस सेशन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक डिज़ाइन। इन प्रीवियस टू वीडियोस अबाउट द कॉम्बिनेशनल लॉजिक डिज़ाइन वी हैव talked about the combinational circuits, difference between combinational sequential circuits, its different forms, canonical form, its conversion. We have started with the K-map, then we have studied the K-map in SOP. Now in this lecture our objective is to discuss about K-map in POS form and to quickly go through 5 and 6 variable K-maps. Let us start with our topic, that is K-map in POS form, that is product of sum. As we know that in POS form, if the value of variable is 0, it is considered as uncomplemented form, and if the value of variable is 1, it is considered as complemented form. We also know that we are using gray codes in K-map. Why to use the gray code? The reason is that if you move from one cell to the next cell, there should be change in only one variable, and that is possible if we use gray codes. If we use binary code, this condition is not satisfied. Why this condition is required? To find out adjacent cells and to reduce the variable. So this is the simple representation of the three variable K-map in the vertical manner. We can represent the K-map in horizontal manner also, that we have studied in previous lecture. Observe here, one more thing in POS is that you have to group adjacent zeros. In SOP, we have grouped adjacent ones. Now observe, this is an example taken from the Floyd book. How many zeros are there? 4 zeros are there. Quad means group of 4 adjacent ones or 4 adjacent zeros. Quad will be possible here? No, because this all zeros are not adjacent zeros. What they have done? For each and every cell, they have represented its corresponding max terms, that is for 0 a b c, that is the first 0 0 0. We know that in case of POS, a complement, that is a value is 0, it is returned as uncomplemented. That's why a plus b plus c. In the second case, that means for this 0, if value of a is 0 and b is 1, that's why a b is 1, that's why b bar, and c is 0, that's why c. So this is how we are writing all these values. Reduction we will discuss afterwards. For the 4 variable K-map, as we know, again these are the gray codes. These are the gray codes used over here. Here also gray codes and corresponding mean terms. Remember that A is most significant bit over here. We can write AB over here and CD over here. Accordingly, these horizontal numbers will become vertical. Now observe here. This is 0th cell because A0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 is 0. 1, 2 and 3. Because these gray numbers you have used, remember there is 2 over here. 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then 8th cell will be over here. That is 1, 0, 0, 0. You will observe 1, 0, 0, 0. Right? This is 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. This is how we have to represent. Observe this example. Here again, these one zeros are given. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 zeros, which are not at all adjacent. They have represented its sum form, max term, sum for every max term separately. Grouping is not yet done. Here, observe this example. Grouping is done. these two zeros, sorry, these two zeros are grouped together because we know the condition, that is called as pair. Pair will reduce only one variable that we have studied. We have to write down only the constant term. For this and this, value of a and b is 0 0, right? That's why I will write a b. And if you observe this and this numbers, c is changing from 0 to 1, that's why c is removed, and d is constant, which is 0. That's why the answer a b, a plus b plus d. Now observe this vertical chord. For this chord, if you observe carefully, value of b and d changing everywhere, constant is only cd, that's why c plus d. And again for this one, pair a is 1, b is 0, that's why a bar b. And here from this to this cell, d is changing from 0 to 1, so the one which is changing we will remove and the constant we will write, that's why you will get this answer. Mapping the standards of expression. Observe here, the one expression is given, sum of product expression is given. You can simplify, you can map in this K-map. If you observe carefully, every expression is having only all the four terms are present. That means these are singles, because we know that single will not reduce any variable. So what we can do, the simple example is there. A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar. First of all, this expression is in SOP. So we know that in SOP, A bar means 0. So write down corresponding mean terms. This one is 0. That is 1000 is 8. 1100, 8 plus 4, 12, and so on. And in 4 variable K map, draw one 4 variable K map and enter all the ones in this mean terms, and other will be 0, and you can simplify. Mapping the standard POS expression. If the expression is like this, sorry, then what we can do, this is a sum expression. We can write in that cells as write in previous example that I have explained you, write as this ones in this corresponding cells and group the remaining cells, so that will become POS, and you can then simplify. With the don't care condition, basically don't care condition means we are writing the cross mark over there. So don't care conditions are considered as 1 or they are considered as 0. Therefore, our benefit, by using that don't cares, if you are, it is possible to make a group or make a chord or make pair. If it is easier, then you can consider that as a 1. Otherwise, you can neglect that. Observe here the first example. See, there was a don't. Imagine there is a 0 over here. Then what will happen if there is a 0? Then you would have to group this together and then this together. And you know the pair will reduce only one variable. So in that case, this is a 4 variable K map. So 3 variable for this plus 3 variable. So how many logic gates you require? An AND gate with 3 inputs. One more AND gate with 3 inputs. And then one OR gate like this you require, which is not the reduced one, right? Instead of that, if you consider don't care here and here, so observe, if there is a don't care over here, that means if there would be a 1 over here, you could have grouped this like this and you will get the answer as A, which is simply A. You will require only one line, not a AND gate or NOT gate. And what about this don't care? It is not required because all the ones are included. So neglect it. Unnecessary, don't add the extra terms. So this is how you can use the don't care. K map with the don't care conditions. One more question they have given. Observe here. हाउ मेनी टाइम्स दे हैव रिटन द डोंट केयर? 1 2 3 4 5 6. इफ डोंट केयर वुड नॉट बी देयर देन वॉट यू विल डू? इफ डोंट केयर इज नॉट देयर देन यू वुड हैव ग्रुप दिस टू वंस टूगेदर एंड यू विल गेट अ टर्म. जस्ट ऑब्जर्व हियर. ए बी बार सी बार वुड बी द टर्म. इफ द डोंट केयर इज प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर देन ऑक्टेट विल बी ग्रुप्ड एंड ओनली ए इज देयर, राइट? एंड हियर यू विल ग्रुप देम इन पेयर एंड अगेन वन वेरिएबल इज रिड्यूस्ड. कंपेयर दिस टू ऑप्शन विदाउट डोंट केयर एंड विथ डोंट केयर. सॉरी, विदाउट डोंट केयर मोर नंबर ऑफ द लॉजिक गेट्स रिक्वायर्ड टू इम्प्लीमेंट. Pi capital M is the POS expression. The mean terms are given. D means don't care terms. You can simplify and solve, get the answer like this. This one is the answer. Observe here, not required to include the only don't care. This one is not required, so neglect it. Five variable Kmap. You will observe the five variable Kmap. If there are the five variables, there will be 32 conditions, that is M0 to M31. So what we will do? Let us consider V is the most significant bit. So your bit is V, W, X, Y and Z. These are the 5 bits. If you try to write down the truth table, you will write down 16 times V is 0 and 16 times it is 1. And the next this conditions will remain same. 0 to 15 and again 0 to 15, right? So we are using this logic. So V is equals to 0, one 4 variable Kmap by using the remaining 4 variable, and for V is equals to 1, one more 4 variable Kmap by using remaining 4 variables, and the corresponding mean terms are given. Task is that how to find out adjacent cells. For that, very simple answer is that imagine you are superimposing one Kmap on the top of the other. Just imagine you are placing one Kmap on the top of the other. Then the cells which will overlap, or the cells which are one below the other, are the adjacent cells. And the other rules are same. That means horizontal cells are adjacent, vertical cells are adjacent, and so on. So, is it clear that you will just superimpose one Kmap on the top of the other and you will get the cells which are overlapping will be the adjacent cells. Now observe, M0 will be adjacent cell with M16, M5 will be M21, M10 will be M26, M9 will be there with M25, and so on. How to simplify? We will enter 1 in corresponding cells which are given in the above expression, because the expression is given in soft form. As we have observed how to find out the adjacent cells, the cells which are overlapping on the one other will be considered as the adjacent cells. Yes, the adjacent cells are this one. First we will form a chord from this and this, as shown by this arrow. Then again this one and this one form a pair. In this, A will be reduced because it is changing, right? A will be reduced. Value of BC is same for this. BC is same for this also, this also. A so answer will be BC and B E dash, B C D E dash, right? So this is the grouping. For these two ones, they will be grouped together in this K map only. This is also grouped together. So two pairs in this, one more pair with this cell number 14 and 30. For this also one more pair, and then a chord, and this also two will be grouped together. So this is how we will solve this five variable. Again, one more example. You can note it down and simplify. This is also one more example of 5 variable K map. For 6 variable K map, there will be 6 variables in total. 2 raised to 6, that is 64 combinations. Then the most significant 2 bits E and F will be considered as 0 0, means write down, let us write down E over here and F over here. So for 0 1 and again for 0 and 1, similarly for 2 variable K map. Remaining 4 variables A, B, C, D you will write here. When E and F is 0 0, if we considered E as MSB, whenever E is 0, F is 0. Remaining 4 variable K map, then E is 0, F is 1. One more 4 variable K map, 1 0, one more, and for 1 1, one more. In this case, how will you find out adjacent cells? Imagine you are placing one K map on the top of the other, and the cells which will overlap are considered at the adjacent cells. So this is how we can use this K map, 6 variable K map. But as the number of variable increases, K map will become more complicated to solve. That's why for that we will simplify by using Quinn-McCluskey method, and the K map will be very simple up to 4 variable K map.